Up to 300 persons have been involved in this at NTNU, if you count everything from professors to bachelor students, master students, PhD candidates, postdoctoral candidates, and people collaborating from also companies and from government. So this is a really big effort together. So we have had interdisciplinary collaboration, but with a laser focus on the application. And that is the reason I think we are actually world-leading now and have a world-leading infrastructure at the moment of now. When we have made this technology here and tested it in Trondheim and also rolling it out, it can be scaled out to other cities in the world. There are many cities who have waterways. They were founded traditionally at waterways, so there's a lot of these areas where you can have such ferries. In time, the technology can also be further developed to be used along, for instance, coastlines to transport people to islands or wherever they want to live, more on demand instead of going in a fixed schedule. So we kind of again start from the bottom up, and then we can scale up and populate the waterways of the world with this type of environmentally friendly and self-driving ferries, and then scale it up to coastlines and so on. So we think there's a huge potential in this.